The Tasman Environment Plan is important because we live in such a special place, and the process is everyone's opportunity to get involved and have their say about how they want the Tasman region to develop in the future and what they want the environment to be like in the future, not only for us but our children and their children. The Tasman Environment Plan, it's about explaining how we are going to live and work in Tasman and look after our environment while we do that. The concept of kiuta kitai, the mountains to the sea, is really fundamental to the Tasman Environment Plan. It's about how everything is connected, right through from the mountains, through to the rivers, the ocean, the land, the people. It's important for everyone to understand how they fit within their local environment, the places that they work, the places that they live, and the places that they visit.
The Tasman Environment Plan relates to our regional economy in many ways. Our regional economy is largely underpinned by primary production, so the forestry industry, farming, horticulture, aquaculture in our marine environment, and tourism, which takes advantage of all of the areas that we so enjoy living in this region for. Our diversity of landscapes, people live in them, they work in them, we recreate in them. So trying to strike that balance to enable the economic activity to continue while managing any adverse effects that that creates to ensure that future generations can enjoy the lifestyle, the access to the outdoors, clean water, clean air, all the reasons that people both shift here and continue to live here is probably the most important part of the overall planning process. So I think a really good example is the area that I live in. So in Eaves Valley, we have a range of different land uses, so horticulture, apple growing, agriculture, a large sawmill, the district's landfill, Dock Scenic Reserve, and a significant amount of forestry. So in a relatively small parcel of land, all of those activities coexist. And so it's perfectly possible to balance all those different land uses, to manage the environmental effects, to provide for economic, social, cultural, and environmental outcomes. But it does require planning, and it does require people to consider all of those things working together and how they balance.
This is the Rural 3 Zone, which is a zone where Council's been trying through our Tasman Resource Management Plan to provide for rural lifestyle living. Rural lifestyle living in the Rural 3 Zone has provided a lot of terrific outcomes in a lot of locations, as a lot of people can live in here with relatively low impact. Visually it's quite hidden from the main road, and it's featured some very strong clustering of housing along the ridgeline here, and it was balanced by providing some of the larger productive blocks, which we can see down here on the lower slopes. Going forward, as we look to develop our new Tasman Environment Plan, we will be looking at options to have this sort of rural lifestyle living with lower impact and provide more of a community heart. So whether that can be a very small medical centre or a cafe, or you know, provide some of those amenities that can really sort of bring a community together so that people don't have to travel so much. Another important aspect of the Rural 3 subdivisions is to promote restoration of natural habitats, and we can see some strong planting along the stream side here to really support the biodiversity and to bring birds and fish back into these streams.
So biodiversity means a whole range of things, right down from the bugs that we have in our soil and our plants through to the animals. So it's the whole range of life and living things on our land and our sea. The state and trend of biodiversity in the Tasman District is very similar to the rest of New Zealand, and we are trending downwards. We are losing biodiversity all the time. Biodiversity is a big topic in New Zealand right now. The Tasman Environmental Plan, it's our chance as people living in our district to have a say in how the plan shapes our district and how we protect, enhance and restore our environment to make it a better place for us and for the kids and future generations. So I think it's very important to get involved.
I believe that the communities across Tasman are all very special places, and it's important for the community to be able to have a say, have some input to retain the special characters and how they'd like to see the areas develop as they go forward. One of the main drivers, particularly here in Tapuera, is the increasing and conversions of dairy farms to hops, where there's perceived increased use of water, and water allocation and water usage is very important for all communities and something we need to. have your input in it around how you think that should be allocated and used going forward.
The name of this plan is called Aorere Ki Uta, Aorere Ki Tai. And it's a play on a well-known proverb. We endeavour to recognise all things natural and human. And then we endeavour to see how these things are interconnected and combined to make our plan. This is a really significant piece of work, and it doesn't come around often. So we better speak with our community about their values, their priorities, and the things that they want to see in a plan.
The new environmental plan for Tasman will look at each catchment and connect us to the important natural resources that we rely upon: water, land and soil, the air. And then think about what our future needs will be in terms of housing, business, industry, schooling. It's important for the community to be involved in every step of the way, because this is a plan that's for the community, by the community. Good governance requires good partnerships. Partnerships with our iwi, partnerships with our communities, partnership with our stakeholders, our developers, our schools. It's a time in our history where that good planning requires that partnership.
Everyone's got a role to play in how Tasman will be in the future. He waka eke noa, we're all in the same boat together. And the Tasman Environment Plan process is a way that we can have a bit of a pause in the paddling and just make sure that we're all heading in the right direction. We've got some pretty big challenges ahead of us, particularly with our changing climate and improving the habitat for our birds and fish and lizards in the Tasman environment. And we won't achieve those things unless we work as a community and work together.